Hello everyone, I'm Stuti Pandit and today I'm going to present about email tracing. So nowadays, malicious emails are all too frequent. Scams, spams, malware and phishing emails are a common inbox site. If you trace an email back to its source, you have a slight chance of discovering who or where the email comes from. In other cases, you can trace the origin of an email to block a persistent source of spam or abusive content, permanently removing it from your inbox. Server administrators trace email for the same reason. With the ever-increasing penetration of computers in our lives, emails have become a vital source of communication. It is quickly becoming the prime medium for business and personal correspondence and is undoubtedly the most popular way we communicate with others on a daily basis. As with any popular technology, email technology is also prone to abuse. With the most people use email for its intended purpose, a very large number use this medium for a completely different goal. Anonymous threats, fraudulent transactions, blackmailing, and even ransom notes. As these cases rise day by day, it becomes imperative that the forensic investigators have the required skills and tools to follow the electronic traces left by an email and nab the culprits. Now let's read about the email headers. An email header is a code snip that consists of essential details to authenticate an email message. It precedes the email body and also contains information about the sender and recipient. An email header is more than the to, from, date and subject section that precedes an email body. Headers also play an essential role in recording an email routes, since every email message has an email header. When the email is sent from one address to another, the message will go through mail transfer agent, so email headers will show. If the email was sent to other addresses before reaching the final destination. If the header information looks suspicious, users can avoid engaging with the email. Headers use metadata to provide information about the transmission process. Suspicious, users can avoid engaging with the email. Headers use metadata to provide information about the transmission process. First step in tracing an email is having a thorough understanding of the email process. A broad outline of the step is given in the presentation. The first step is mail user agent. The mail user agent is a program such as Outlook, Thunderbird or Outlook Express run by the user to read, reply to, compose and dispose of emails. The second is mail transfer agent or the message transfer agent. This program is responsible for storing and forwarding or delivering emails. The next is mail delivery agent. The actual program responsible for delivering emails to a user is mail delivery agent. It usually handles one specific type of mail delivery. When you send an email, each intermediate device, MUA, MTA and MDA may insert some headers in the message. These headers can help an investigator to reconstruct the path that the email took to the receiver. The last MUA may apply a filter to the stored mail, causing selected headers to be omitted from the display. This filtering removes the headers from the user's view. Although no headers are actually removed by MUA, this is reason that the user doesn't see the all the headers in the normal mail view. The headers typically omitted are those inserted by the MTAs and those having to do with the transport process and less with the content. Let us see the procedure for email tracing and for identifying the IP address of sender. Firstly, open the email and click on Show Original. Then the email header will be shown. Now open it, copy it and open the new tab. Now open email header analysis in new tab and copy the email header. Then paste the email header in the column and click on analyze header. Then the IP address will be shown. Copy it and open IP locator in new tab, and then paste the IP address in the IP locator. Then you will be able to see the latitude, longitude of the place of the sender. Now let us see the importance of email in forensic investigation. So email is one of the most important thing that the forensic investigator can look at during an investigation. As a forensic tool, email is extraordinarily useful in that it can document a suspect's activity, sign, dated and with witnesses. It can prove guilt, prove innocence or prove that something happened, all with the date stamp. Email addresses are often used as usernames for websites. So when you can find an email address for a suspect, that gives you a jumping off point for internet searches. You can use that email address to search for the for other email addresses the suspect might have from the free providers such as yahoo.com, gmail.com, hotmail.com and outlook.com, etc. Knowing one email address of a suspect can lead to a lot more info. So this is up for my presentations. Thank you very much for listening.